Hey everyone, it's Eric, and I'm here to talk about how to rig a very simple arm and how to use smart actions to improve on that arm. And I want to talk about also some of the things that you can do wrong that will make you frustrated, and maybe you won't be frustrated anymore after watching this. Smart actions can be a bit confusing at first. So we're going to start with stuff that is incredibly basic, and you'll roll your eyes and go, I know how to make a rectangle. But I'm hoping that very quickly you might learn something new if you're a beginner. So just, I'm in Moho, but this will all work in Anime Studio as well. I'll just go to File, New, create a new object, or a new file. And I'm just going to create my arm really fast. So let me get the Rectangle tool. I'm going to create a very simple arm. Just drag out a rectangle for my arm, and for the hand, I'm just going to draw a square. Let me align that a little bit. There we go. There's an arm. It may be the most simple arm in the world, but it's an arm. I'm also going to double click on the layer it's on and name it arm, because I like to name things so I can see what they are quickly. It'll save you a lot of time in the long run, I think. Okay, so now we need to rig this arm, which means putting bones into it and having them be controlled. So I'm going to go to my layers palette. I'm going to click the new layer, and I'm going to go down and choose group. Go down and choose bone. There's bone. It's come up. You see that it's called layer 2, but it's got the white box. It wants me to name it. Let me name it. I'll call this arm bones. And for any bones in there to control the arm, they need to be inside the bone group. So I just select my arm layer, I click and drag over top of the bones layer. You can see that box appears around the arm bones layer. I let go. You can see that the arm layer has indented. That means now it's inside the arm bones layer. So let's add some bones. Click on the arm bones layer, get the add bones tool. I'm gonna click and drag a bone from around the shoulder to around where the elbow would be. And at the tip of that, I'm going to then click and drag out from the elbow to the wrist, and then I'll draw a hand bone. There we go. So let's see how that works. I'll get to my manipulates bone tool, and see, it's being controlled, but you can see the bones are bending, but the arm isn't. That's because this is a vector program. And the vectors are these points. When I select them, they turn red. And anything in a vector layer is going to be made up of these dots. They're called points. And the lines between them, which are either curved or straight. But the line would not bend where the elbow is. We need to add some vectors at the elbow. So let me get my Add Points tool. I'll move over the rectangle at the elbow, and you can see the little red box appears there. The little red dot appears there. I'll click that, added a point. There's my little red dot on the underside. Click. There. Now I've added points at the elbow. So let's go back to the bone layer. Manipulate bones. There. Now it's bending. But it's also pinching when it bends in. And one of the rules of animation is to keep your volume consistent, and a real arm doesn't do this. An arm is not a garden hose. So let's fix that. Step number one, the arm's a bit rubbery as well. Let's adjust the bone strength, because you only really need enough bone strength around the bone to control what you're trying to control, which means the forearm really only needs to be as much strength as it takes to cover the forearm, the top of the arm. There we go. So I'm just getting my bone strength tool, dragging to the right makes it bigger, and everything inside that pink box is going to be controlled by that bone. That bone's going to try and take control, so it's going to give you really bad results. So let me bring that in. So it's just enough to kind of cover the rectangle. This one the same. And the hand looks pretty good. So let's... Yeah, see, that's better. But we still got the pinch. So let's fix that with a smart action. So I'll go to the window. I'll choose actions. And there's my actions palette. And we're going to create a smart bone, which means that it's a bone that when it rotates will have an effect, will do something you've defined. So I'm going to add that smart action to the forearm bone, which is the one that we bend and everything pinches. So I'll click that. And right now that bone is named B2. That's just an automatically named bone. If you've got a lot of actions, the actions are named after the bones, and you're looking at your actions palette, it's really hard to tell what is what just by going down the list. So let's name this bone. I'll just rename it forearm. There. Now, when I select this bone, and make sure I'm on the bone layer, I can now go into the actions palette, click add action, and it comes up. And notice the action name is automatically assigned as forearm. Because it's naming it after the bone I've got selected. This is good. Let me show you some mistakes people make. I see this a lot. People often, there's the bone selected, but I'm on the arm layer and not the arm bone layer. So I'm going to go ahead, still selected, click the add action. Hey, the bone is named forearm, but the action is called action one. Something's wrong. That's when you cancel and go figure out that you're probably not on your bone layer. But say you forget to even check that and just click OK. There's your clue number two. That pink in the timeline that just appeared should not be pink, it should be blue. So when it turns pink like that, you know something's wrong and it's time to stop, breathe, and figure out what's going on. Now in the actions palette, you can see a little red arrow pointing at action one, which is the one I just created. That means we're editing that. So I need to come out of there. I'll go to mainline, double click. That's your main animation area. I'll click on action one and click my trash can, get rid of it, it's gone. Let's come back up to the arm bone layer, make sure that forearm is selected, add action, hey, it's called forearm, click OK. There, it's blue too, hey, hooray. So what we need to do now is create the action, and you want to give it enough frames so that the action takes place smoothly. I usually come out to about 4 seconds, frame 96. It's really easy to know. You just remember what frame you usually end on. 96 is a good target because it's got that gray line for 4 seconds if you're working at 24 frames per second. I'm on 96. And so I'm just going to get my transform bone tool and I'm going to rotate that bone in that direction. And there's my big old pinch. So I'm going to come down to the arm layer. Look, it's still blue. So everything's still good. I'll get my transform points tool. And I will just adjust it so it's not pinching. And I can also get my curvature tool. And this is Moho, so I've got these handles. But if you're on Anime Studio and don't have the handles, don't worry. The curvature tool, just click right on the point, drag to the left to go sharper or to the right to go rounder. So I'm going to give it a little bit more sharpness at that elbow. And then I'm going to... That actually looks pretty good, but when we come out to about 48, that elbow's getting fat. So let me go ahead and just, at that point, just edit it a little bit so it's not getting so fat. And for the purposes of this, demonstration, I think that's pretty much good enough. I'm going to fix that elbow just a bit more. There we go. That looks pretty good. So we'll come back out to the main line, just double click on it in the actions. I'm going to go to the bone layer, get my manipulate bones tool. And you can see now it's doing what the smart action defined. If I go the other way, it still pinches. That's because we still need another action. And don't try and correct both directions in a single action. You can create two actions, so only have one direction of bone rotation in each of your smart bone actions. A lot of people try to put it all in one action, and I get a lot of questions from people about what's going wrong, and the answer is you should have two actions, one for each direction. So I'm going to go ahead and make sure that forearm bone is selected. I'll click add action. Hey, see, it's called forearm two. It's the second action. And so space two after the name of the bone defines the other possible action you can put on the bone. You can have two. Click OK. Hey, everything's blue. Get my transform bone tool and bend it this way. We've got the same problem, and I didn't pay any attention. I'm on frame one. So I'll just click and drag that out to frame 96. There we go. Always pays to pay attention, but it's easy to fix. I'll come out to 96. I will correct this arm the way I corrected it the other time. I like these handles. They're worth upgrading for. Let's watch it. Same problem around 48. It's a bit fat. Bring that in a bit. And then there we go. I'll double click on mainline to get back out, go to the bone layer, get the manipulate bones tool. And there, I have rigged a working arm. Now you can, of course, get more complicated with your arm designs, and you can get more complicated with your smart actions. But I'm hoping that if you were struggling with understanding smart actions, you now have a better idea of how they work. So thank you very much for watching.